This is PC747. Drones are getting cheaper, and that's going to be a good thing for the industry. Yeah, I mean, you know, about a year ago, I was playing around with this, with a couple of drones. The first one, I was able to snag a DJI Phantom 4, a professional model, for, you know, a steal. Now, when I got a chance to see how much it actually costs, you know, yeah, I was like, wow, you know, drones are, yeah, quite a bit of money as far as investments. Now, when you look at your DJI, your Phantoms, and your Mavericks, you know, DJI is pretty much the go-to for professionals. Because the cameras are awesome. The software is great. You know, it pretty much does a good job as far as knowing everything someone will need to utilize it for a business. I know several people that utilize it for their business. And if you ever flew a Phantom, it's pretty much almost easy to fly. With that said, you can't help to still feel that concern when you take off with the drone. Because you're seeing $700, $800, $900, depending on how much you pay for that drone, literally flying away. And you hope it comes back to you in one piece and not pieces. And that right there is the biggest concern for a lot of people with drones. The fear factor. The money you're going to pay for this, and will you be able to fly this thing and get it back to you without being out of a lot of money? And that's where I think the industry will benefit from cheaper drones. In my case, I actually bought a cheaper drone just to play around with, you know, because I wanted to actually fly around with it and try to learn it without having to use all the navigation and stuff. And so I picked one up that was right around $50, you know, with an extra $20 on top of that. I got an extra case, a couple of batteries, and went out flying with it. Now, it was a little bit more challenging to fly it around because it didn't have all the fancy navigational systems that my DJI did. But I gotta be honest, I had a lot more fun flying it. For one, when I did fly it, I wasn't nervous. I wasn't, you know, worried about something happening where, you know, I'll take off with it and it crashed and then went out a lot of money. In fact, the cheaper drone, because the way it was built was much lighter, it was able to take a crash. I mean, I crashed it several times. And the most that happened was I bent the blade, which was able to be bent back easily, or the leg popped off, but that popped back in place just as easily. And this brings me to a point that I think, in order for the industry to truly take off the way they need for it to, they're going to have to invest in more cheaper drones. And even if would invest in it, they're going to have to look sort of like what the smartphone industry did, where your cheaper drones actually get a little bit better. I mean, don't just put out some crap. Actually make it a pretty decent drone. You know, we're not asking for the greatest of cameras, but put a pretty decent camera on there. And you'll find a lot more people flocking to it. And it looks like DJI is looking at that for themselves, because you look at the Spark that they put out, about a year ago. Yeah, $350, a much smaller drone, a smaller footprint. You know, easier to fly around, and something that somebody gonna be more willing to pay for than their Maverick in the Phantom series. And then you look at the Tello at $99. You know, I saw a review on it. The camera's not that bad. It still have a lot of the navigational features that is known with your DJI drones, yet it's still light, it's still compact. Like I said, it's cheaper. So you're gonna have people more willing to make the investment in that. Look, you're gonna always have a need for your professional drones. Now, for those out there in the industry that's looking to get quality photos and footage that can be utilized for whether it be movies, television series, for your insurance companies, all those different companies and industries that rely on that, they're going to want something as professional as the Phantom and the Maverick and with the photos they're able to take. But for everyone else that just want to play around with something, they're not going to be quite willing to spend $1,000, even $800. especially when you think about it, majority of drones have like about 45-minute battery life on one battery, which means if you want to get more time out of it, you either got to sit around and wait for that to charge up, or you're going to invest in more money for more batteries. And look, DJI can take advantage of this. In fact, I actually purchased a Parrot Mambo. And, you know, with it came with a little cannon that you could shoot out pellets and a little grabbing tool. And I thought, it's kind of nice to have to play around with, a little unique. And yeah, if companies are willing to go to more cheaper drones that people can pick up, they can make up some money on accessories as people buy more batteries and more other things they can put with it. And yet, for those that don't have the money to spend all that extra, they at least have the basis to get around flying with. This is PC 747. I'm out.